Sand looks familiar. I don't think it's quite as good as the opener that we had in our match one game one, but it's close. The curve is relatively low. If we hit on time and Omen Speaker finds us a third land, we're gonna go Wave Crash Triton into Feral Invocation, which is pretty strong against his deck. I think we can keep it. Heck, just the Omen Speaker is good against a Crone Crusader if we hit our land on time. You see, guys, the reason you keep the one landers is because you got three lands on top of your deck. It's that simple. I don't know why it's even a discussion. Yeah, he just has to pass it back 'cause I have a 1/3. Sweet, right? In Owen Turtenwald wrote an article recently about free attacks, attacks that don't have any bad repercussions if the opponent like calls. It's like a free bluff. Like he could have just attacked with the Traveling Philosopher here, and then there's a chance that I don't block with the Omen Speaker, and he just gets in 2 damage for free. That sort of thing. I think Wave Crash Triton's better than Triton Fortune Hunter in this situation, because I have Ordeal of Nylea and Feral Invocation to make the Wave Crash like a legitimate threat. Should be able to carry the game in its own right. Now I kind of just want to go Triton Fortune Hunter Sedge Scorpion because that's a better clock. Probably bad though. I think we want to get these counters on as soon as possible. Is it pro blue? But like, the Triton attacking is going to be a 2/5, so he'll block it. And the only way it dies is if he has a deal 3 damage to target creature. And then that's trading 2 for 2. I'm very fine with that. If the Ordeal of Nylea did not give it a counter to make it a 2/5 as opposed to a 1/4. Oh, I see. I see. So maybe he is planning to magma jet it. That's the only reason I can see for this block. Makes a lot of sense. So he just 3 for 2'd me, which is fine. Like my hand is like he's short on cards, and my hand is pretty gassy, so I should be all right. This guy like clone stuff, or whenever it becomes a tapped, you may pay 2. If you do, put a token on the battlefield. It's a copy of another target creature, except it's an enchantment. Gains haste. It's weird that it's enchantments. Okay. I think that's fine. Gives me a reason to play this Hedge Scorpion because I don't want him to be able to tap the Spirit Binder for free and get like free triggers that way. Well, not free triggers, he'd still have to pay for them, but you get what I mean. Like deny him access to that ability. Aqueous Swarm's a pretty good draw. If I don't draw a land to play the Chimera next turn. I can just go Feral Invocation, Aqueous Form. Be in pretty hot shape. When the Spirit Binder copies a creature, it's not going to be able to copy the enchantments on it. Sudden Storm, excellent card here. Very happy about that. Not pleased about missing land drops, but what can you do? I almost don't want to attack with this Triton, but I get a scry if I attack. I would have drawn the land anyway. Yeah, I'm not sure about that attack. In the context of this board state, because I'm dealing him 4 damage and then I'm letting him hit me for 4, 5, 6, 7 damage. Kind of awkward, unless I decide to trade the Scorpion with the flanks, then the Spirit Binder just gets to untap. Yeah, I snap make that attack if I'm him too. Just gonna block like that. This is a situation where the information might actually matter, so I'm attacking first. I think I want that. Yeah, I definitely want that. Get him to 12. So it looks like I'm like intentionally letting him win a race, but the Chimera is actually relevant. It's a relevant blocker. It's the reason I traded this Hedge Scorpion with his Minotaur, so that he couldn't just copy this and overwhelm me with a pile of bodies, a pile of giant bodies. So he has this guy, which can pump his dudes, but the Chimera can actually like get in front of the Crusader or the Traveling Philosopher because he's stuck on 4 lands here. So I think I've navigated my way into a winning board state. We're gonna draw a forest next turn, play the Cure's Follower. Wish that this card wasn't in my deck. I don't know what it's doing in here. After I've played with it some, like I've never wanted to cast it. I've never wanted to risk bricking on it when I could be doing something awesome like drawing extra cards or tapping down his threats. There's just not enough time to dirtle. He's offering a trade of sorts. I think I just take the 4 damage. Yeah, because I'm going to Sudden Storm him. Yeah, for sure. The only awkward thing is if he God's Blessings to give Pro Blue next turn. Kind of makes me want to offer the trade. Yep. Could definitely see people not agreeing with that block. That was probably the worst card he could have had for me in that situation. I was worried about getting blown out by another God's Willing when I went to Sudden Storm. And then just like all of a sudden being at a very low life total. Maybe should have cast this on his upkeep. But he maybe would have like bestowed or something. If he drew a bestow card. The scry here is very valuable. Because I need like a little bit of something to put him out. Why not, he says. That's a really good sign. When they start complaining, it's a good sign, folks. Nullify. How do I feel about that card? I kind of like it. Kind of like it, kind of don't. Gonna bottom it. Think the cards that he could top deck to interact with me are like ways of dealing with this Triton Fortune Hunter, and the Nullify doesn't actually stop that, and it doesn't impact his board, so I don't like it. Pretty awesome draw. Maybe shouldn't have traded the heroes there. Pretty awesome card to see on top of my deck. Because it means even if he deals with a Triton Fortune Hunter, he's still going to lose to the Nellie's Disciple. Cool, and there's the match. Yeah, when I made the block, I was thinking the Crusader had more value to him, excuse me, in play than my Cures follower did. This was already representing a lethal clock. That might have been faulty logic, though. Oh man. Well, thanks for watching, guys. See you next week. Hopefully, I'll be a little bit more rested. Maybe get to play this new standard format. I don't know. Maybe I'll just do more limited videos. This was fun. I had fun. So, yeah, good games.